I'm Chris. All right, let's take a look at some stuff. All right, let's get out of this PowerPoint thing. Here, we'll go ahead and show this slide since I clicked it. I'm going to briefly show this tool. We've talked about it a number of times on here. This is the link. We're just going to show it briefly, but there you go. It's JSONify, and what we're going to be using is the SVG two column format stuff. That's how they did it. Okay, let's get out of there, and let's go on over to our Warrior Horses site. Right, so everyone's got their classic Warrior Horses site, and of course, everyone needs to plan their attacks. And when you plan your attack, you want to track the status and who you want to attack, right? So we've created a attacks list over here. And just for space, here's a quick tip. If you haven't seen this before, if you add this env, so environment equals web view, to the end of your list, you get this much nicer, well, not nicer necessarily, but larger view, right? So I've got rid of all that extra Chrome so that I can demo just a little bit better. All right. So now what we're going to do is we've got a list. It's just got our targets over here, and it's got the status of those targets. The status is pretty straightforward. It's just one of those choice columns. Very quickly, though, just to make it easier, I'm going to format this column and add one of my favorite tricks on the bottom to make this work a little better. Come on, conference Wi-Fi. Here we go. We are live in person in Vegas. There we go. All right. So we'll go to the very bottom. Again, we can do this any format. Just go to the very bottom. We're going to hit comment. I'm going to type in inline edit field. All right. And I'm going to say at current field. And when I do that little magic, all right, now I get this box. So let's save that. And now it's still my regular old choice column, but I can change things directly here, which makes it a little easier for the rest of the demo. Okay. So but what I want to be able to do is visualize this, right? So this is pretty straightforward. We attack, we destroy, we win, right? And maybe we have a little planning period. But there may have a much more complicated process. Maybe you've got lots of different gates you've got to go through, all sorts of stuff, or you want to describe it in some fancy way. And your CEO just came to you. He's just discovered SmartArt in 2025. Congratulations, right? So let's take a look how we can bring SmartArt into a format. Woo-wowie! So we'll go back to our PowerPoint, and we're just going to add a new slide because we're going to do it right here. Okay. And we'll just say go to our insert menu, and we're going to go SmartArt, which is right there. And you can pick any of these. I'm going to pick, let's do this one with the arrows. It's got nice three things for me, and we'll say, what do we say? Attack, destroy, and then win, right? And of course, you can add more, do whatever you need, choose one of these other ones. I'm going to change the colors. I don't need to because we're going to override them with theme colors, but it's fun too. You can resize whatever you know, all that stuff. Click on this little border, and you're going to right click, and you're going to say save as picture. And this part's important here. You want to save as SVG, right? So if you make sure it's an SVG, so a scalable vector graphic. That's going to kind of preserve all of those shapes that the format can draw again. Let's just save that guy. And then I'm going to head over to Visual Studio Code, so VS Code, right here, because I've already got it open to the folder where I've got my new SVG. Wow, look at that. That's beautiful. Okay, so we've got that. Now, if I want to see what that actually is, so SVGs are really just XML files underneath, so that means they're text-based. So I can reopen the editor with the text editor. And there, look, I wasn't lying. There it is. Oh, beautiful. Of course, we all understand that perfectly, right? That's that pretty arrow with the boxes. And if I want to make that a format, I've got to do just a little bit of cleanup on this, right? So I'm going to right-click on this guy, and I'm going to reveal in Finder if you're on Mac, or reveal in File Explorer if you're in Windows. And there it is. And I've got an open source tool called Inkscape. It's free. I've got it installed, and I'm going to open this SVG up in it. There we go. And I've got the layers window open just so we can see. One of the problems here is things are grouped and things are text elements. So when it comes to list formatting, we can draw SVGs. We put an SVG element, and then we can have individual path elements, and that's it, right? So rectangles, circles, text, all of those kind of named special elements do not work, and they're not going to come over. So we need to get rid of them. It also doesn't work very well with strokes. So luckily, Inkscape makes that really, really easy. We're going to go to Edit, and we're just going to make sure we've got everything picked. So I'm going to say Select All and All Layers. I've got these instructions for you on a slide. You'll be able to pause them later. All right, and we come up here, and we're going to go to Object, and we're going to Ungroup. We got rid of one group, and let's do it again. Ungroup. Now we've gotten rid of all of our groups over here. I'm going to go to Path. I'm going to say Object to Path. That gets rid of my text-specific objects. It makes all that text into an actual object. Then I also want to make sure I get rid of my strokes. And so I can say strokes to paths. right? So what that does, that's those outlines. If I've got any of those, it also makes them paths. But now it introduced new groups. That's all right. I'm just going to go back up to object and ungroup one more time until everything's flat. That's all I needed. It's all flat. Now I'm going to save. If I save it by default in Inkscape, Inkscape gets really verbose in its XML. It's like, I bet you wanted a bunch of extra text in here, and you didn't. All right, so you're going to do save as. And this is where you're going to pick optimized SVG. I think is how you pronounce that. All right, so pick optimized SVG here. And you're going to get this little wizard. And you're pretty much going to check all these boxes. But again, I've got that in the instructions here. What we're going to do is we're going to shorten the values. We're going to convert CSS attributes to XML attributes, which is a little weird because XML attributes aren't supported in formatting. But we're going to have JSONify take care of that for us. And by doing this, it strips out extra style elements. So it's a little weird. And it makes sure that any IDs that get generated in these SVG files get eliminated because we don't need them. And we're just going to check all these. Basically, just make it smaller. We don't need all this other junk. We don't need IDs. Boom. We say replace it. That's fine. It's a live demo. What could go wrong? All right, there we go. We'll go back in here. Oh, look at that. So now here's that same SVG. It's a little cleaner, right? It's all paths. That's close to what we want. I'm not even reading this. I don't care. I'm just following the instructions. But now because I have JSONify installed here, I'm going to right-click and say convert to SV list format. And there's my format. So I'm just going to copy that, and we'll just trust it did it. Yeah, it sounds good, right? All right, and we'll go back over to our site here, and we're just going to put it on the title field for now. I'll tell you what, let's actually add a column. It'll be more fun that way. Set a random text column, or you can add a calculated column with a value of just double quotes if you want to make it not editable. This case is a text because it's easier. All right, and we'll just say progress. That sounds great. Right, and we'll say save. We don't really care what's in it because we're not going to use the value. We're going to column settings, and we're going to format this column. We're going to go to advanced mode, and I'm just going to Command A or Control A to get all of that highlighted, and I'm going to paste in what I got out of JSONify, and we're going to preview that. Ooh, SmartArt right there in our list. Can you believe it? So very exciting. But let's make that a little bit better here because I've still got, 5 minutes? Perfect. We'll go until I don't.
You can go a bit long if needed, so it's fine.
All right, we're here all day, folks. You didn't have any other session doing it, Jen.
A bit long.
All right, so if we look through this, right, you'll notice that still has those colors we picked out in PowerPoint, which may or may not match our site. It's actually not too bad on the Warrior Horses site. Good job, me. I am the, Pope of Design.
That's right.
So, that makes sense. But how do I know which path is which? Well, the easiest way is to start getting silly with it and just go down to where the fill are. And just type in like red preview, which one? Oh, it's the back arrow, right? So that's the arrow that I wanted to change the color on. I'm just going to leave it as is for now because I don't want to mess with it. But I could change that. Here's another one. Let's see what element this is, right? We're just trying to find those boxes. Yep, that's the attack box, right? So now we know that's the attack box. We don't need a color thing. In fact, it'll get in our way because the way we want to style these is we want to use the theme colors. And so in order to use the theme colors, we want to use these predefined classes Microsoft provides for us. And when it comes to SVGs, we get this fill property, which controls the background. But weirdly, if we set this to current color, right, that will inherit the font color of the item, all right, which is a little weird. So now it's got that neutral primary color. So now I can set the font color dynamically. So what I'll do is I'll come up here right above this D attribute. Those are all those fancy coordinates that PowerPoint generated for me, right? And I'll say class, and I can say equals, and I'll say if, you know, that status, right, column. We're going to look at that status column equals attack in this case. All right, here we go. So we've got what we're going to do is where were we? We see here. So we're trying to type in this attack field, right? So we're setting our class. We're setting it dynamically. So we've got an equals to set the start the expression. We're saying if, and we're saying the status equals attack. We're saying MS font color. And in this case, let's get rid of that. We're going to say theme secondary. So when it is that, I want to do my secondary color just because I know that's red on this one, right? And if it's not that, well, then I want you to do my MS font color. Again, we're setting the font color, which is a little weird because we're doing that current color, to neutral primary. And that sounds great, right? And let's see. We'll make sure we add a comma at the end of our property. Let's preview that. Look at that. So the ones that are set to attack now have a red attack, right? And so what we do is we're just going to copy this class right here. And to make this easier for myself next time, I'm going to do this. I'm going to say comment, and I'm just going to put this as the attack. Because the nice thing about formatting is you can add any property you want, and if it's not part of the definition, it'll just ignore it. So I just decided I'm going to add comment there, because when I go to do this later, I'm not going to be able to find that very well, right? So now we come down here, and we'll just find our next one, and we'll do one more of these just for fun. All right, let's see. Probably not that one, because that was white. Let's see. So that's probably the text. You see, this is highly technical. Here we go. Scroll down. Ooh, what do we got up there? There's probably this one. Let's see. So let's try our same old trick of just setting it to red to see if that's the one. It is. We found it. Get rid of the color. Set this guy to current color. Same thing. Whoop, whoop. And then we come up here right before that, and we're going to paste that class thing that we just did up there and change the word attack to destroy. There we go. Let's preview that. Boom. All right. We're just going to keep it that for time. I'm going to save that for now. And then the idea here is if I come in here and I'm changing that to win, well, the win we didn't do, attack. All right. Attack is set up, or I can set it to destroy. Now destroy is highlighted and so on. The idea here is, right, we can make this a lot fancier, but we want to take SmartArt from PowerPoint. Let PowerPoint do all the hard design work, because not everyone is the Pope of design. So let PowerPoint or Word or whoever do all that. Here's another trick. It doesn't have to be SmartArt, right? So PowerPoint, you can grab all your other shapes and other things. So if you built a slide, you know, with a big dashboard type thing, you can export that to an SVG. Now, do keep in mind, like, raster images. So when I say that, like, if you got, like, a bitmap or a PNG, those aren't going to come over, okay? So you're going to have to play with it just a little bit, but that's the basic idea. So let me make sure I show the slide so you can pause on the video later that has those instructions. There we go. Wowee! All right. And one, two, three, four. You have paused it on there and you've seen it. Great. Here's those resources, though, as for the links for the documentation on list formatting up there. And then also, if you want to check out the JSONify, that is what both adds all that syntax highlighting for your expressions in VS Code. But it also adds that SVG format option. And then if you want those little horses down there, that's unrelated, but I like to talk about it.